This is a tour of the spinal cord and major nerves of the body. The spinal cord is a link between the brain and the rest of the body. We have cervical nerves, we have thoracic nerves, we have lumbar nerves. The spinal cord comes down into, it ends in the lumbar region at the conus medullaris. Then we have nerve parts. They're called the cauda equina, or horse's tail. You can see how they fan out. And it continues until it terminates. On the side of the spinal cord, we have the sympathetic trunk. The sympathetic trunk runs parallel to the spinal column. And it contains the sympathetic ganglia, so it can communicate with the spinal cord. We have some major nerves in the pelvic region. This is the femoral nerve. It's going to go down to the leg. And we have the sciatic nerve that's going to go through the greater sciatic notch of the coxal bone. So this is a vertical representation of the spinal cord. You can see the vertebrae are stacked on top of each other. So we have the cervical vertebrae up here, and then we have thoracic vertebrae, and then lumbar. When these vertebrae are stacked on top of each other, you can see there's a hole right here. This hole is called the intervertebral foramen, and the spinal nerves leave through these holes. When we go all the way down to the bottom of the spinal cord, we have the conus medullaris, and then we have the cauda equina, or horse's tail. This model shows the sciatic nerve going through the greater sciatic notch on the coxal bone. So some major nerves of note in the body. We have the cervical nerves in the neck. We have thoracic nerves in the thoracic region. We have lumbar nerves and then sacral nerves in the lower part of the spinal cord. Going down the leg, we have the sciatic nerve. We also have the femoral nerve. It's going to innervate the muscles of the anterior thigh. In the arm, we have the axillary nerve. It's going to innervate the deltoid muscle as well as the teres minor muscles. We have the muscular cutaneous nerve. It's going to innervate the anterior arm muscles. We have the radial nerve. It's going to innervate the extensor muscles of the forearm, the wrists, and the fingers. We have the median nerve. It's going to innervate most of the anterior forearm muscles, like the flexors and the pronators. Note it's median and it goes down the middle. We also have the ulnar nerve. It's on the ulna side of the arm. And it's going to innervate some of the forearm muscles and the interior hand muscles.